Thank you. Detective. You want to know what happened to them? Looks like you'll learn the hard way. Silenced it before I could drain my puppets and fully revive. My congratulations. I'm helpless.
Is it true? Did you murder all those women? Why? Who are you?
I did. But the who and why are of no consequence to you. You'd neither believe nor understand.
It doesn't matter. You'll do no harm to anyone anymore. What's behind that door?
You know perfectly well, Detective. But why not indulge your curiosity?
I've been lost on this altar of evil. I'll do whatever it takes to destroy it, if that means no one else is murdered here.
Thank you, Detective. I knew you could solve it. Now, it's high time I close this case. I've been waiting for this moment for 30 years.
Wait. I know who you are and what he has done, but he must be brought to trial.
No, you have no idea who he is. What he is. He must be stopped. Once and for all, I'll kill him right here, right now. He'll suffer the same fate as his victims.
Then you'll be no better than him. Think of Emily. Is this what she would have you do?
Don't you dare speak her name. You can't stop me, Detective. What are you doing?
There will be no more murders here.
Detectives, you're not looking so good. What on earth happened here? I need to debrief you as soon as possible.
Detective, can you hear me?
You've done well, Detectives. Kate Burrows is here, safe in our custody. Her boyfriend is recovering at the hospital, and Maple Creek is finally at peace. However, we could find neither hide nor hair of the criminal, and Hamilton disappeared into thin air too.
Thank you again, Detective. I owe my life to you, but I'm afraid I'll never feel safe with the killer still on the loose.
He may have gone into hiding, but I haven't stopped hunting him. I never will.